way to vet the direct energy weapons. We've heard about it. It's certainly a possibility. But I'll tell you something. We were spraying with chemtrails over the course of a summer like I've never seen before. We used to wake up, we'd go out and look up and go, well, there goes the blue sky. And sure enough, by 2 o'clock in the afternoon, there would be no blue sky. The sky would be milky white. And now I'm going to segue into this. This was taken on Sunday morning in Thousand Oaks. I'm at the car wash because our car was really dirty from being up in the fire zone. And you will notice right here, it's small. Right there is a jet, and the contrails are coming out from the jet. These are chemtrails, and you can see in this area already it's being turned, the sky's being turned milky white. Look at it. You will see the jet fly. This chemtrail is below the jet. This chemtrail here is above the jet. The jet flies in between the chemtrails. It's a smoking gun. It's the only video that I've ever seen that really shows that the difference between chemtrails and contrails. This is what normal jets do. This, my friends, is something entirely different. If it's aluminum and barium, aluminum is an accelerant. And perhaps this is the reason why the entire fire moved at such speed. That whole area had been sprayed over and over and over and over again. Here's the video, check it out.
Here is a normal jet. Notice it's not leaving chemtrails.
Now watch this, it flies. See, it flies behind this, but below this.
Very quickly behind it. And you'll notice what's incredible about this, it's between two chemtrails. So it shows you that.
I want to show this again. Watch it come in, folks. Here it comes in. It's above this one.
Very quickly
below this one.
And you'll notice what's incredible about this, it's between two chemtrails. So it shows
and notice the way
flying at a lower altitude.
Notice the way this disappears and this doesn't.
In the lower chemtrail. That's the first time I've ever been able to capture anything like that. That's incredible. So we have a real jet with contrails, and then we have the chemtrails that are all over the sky.
Look at that, folks.
Notice the way they billow out.
Look at that.
And linger.
Look at that. I mean, I'm going to stop it here. Do you really think this is normal? Do you think a normal jet's doing that? I mean, what is it going to take for the American people to flipping wake up and demand that this nonsense stop? Because it's gone on and on and on, and it's everywhere. And people never look up. They never look up. So you don't see it. I'm sitting there just, I can't, look at this. Look at this Sunday morning. Look at this. That's not normal. Where's the pushback? Why haven't millions of people said, what are you guys doing to our skies? What are you doing to our skies? California has lost more residents to other states than it got last year. You know what? Right here. I'm going to be part of that statistic. I want out of this place. Highest taxes in the country. Highest gas prices in the country. The most stifling, overbearing permit process in the country. 3 years? 2 to 3 years, folks, before I can rebuild. So when the house is done, I'll be 72 years old. I don't have the stamina for it. I'm moving to Oklahoma City. I can move in. I can be up and running. I can continue making films and writing books and lecturing. And that's what I'm called to do. And all of you, most of you, 99.999% of you who have left comments have stated such. And I'm blown away by that. I'm humbled by it.